Alright guys, so welcome back to brand new Minecraft video. Now today guys, yes, you can see I have a different background behind me. I'm not at a different house, but currently we have no power right now. Even though we have a generator, it's not connected to my Xbox. But guys, as you can see, or actually you can't, but I'm actually using this controller, so you guys may or may not recognize this. This is actually the controller I used to play on my Xbox, but I was able to Bluetooth connect it to my iPad, so now I can play with a controller. And I was also able to sign in on my Xbox account on Minecraft Mobile, which is this right here on my iPad. And so basically, that basically allows me to access Millionaire Mansions and Millionaire Mansions 2. Now, if you guys watched the last video, you will know why I have Millionaire Mansions 2. I said in the last video, in the outro, I may or may not end up getting Millionaire Mansions 2, because like I said, they have way more stuff in Millionaire Mansions 2 than I have in 1. And I ended up getting it. I can already tell now. I can already tell. It was definitely worth it. But yes, guys, without further ado, let's just go right in. So we're going to start actually in this floor right here. So, you know, this is the main floor. You got the living room and you got the kitchen. You guys can see, like, they got way more stuff than they do in Millionaire Mansions 1. You guys know that. One, maybe you played it yourself, and two, you guys saw the video of my house tour last video. They don't have as much stuff as they do in this. I did the same design that I actually did in a video of a Millionaire Mansions 1 video about 2 years ago. I did this design where it's just steps, so it basically goes up a level into the kitchen, which I really like. I really like the design I did. And then they actually have granite countertops, and then I put a fruit bowl right in the middle. Now, you guys probably won't recognize this very well because it's a horrible design by me. It's supposed to be a pantry because they don't actually have real pantries in this, but I tried my best. And then you got two ovens here. What I love about this is it's functional. And there goes the pizza. And like, it even does that. It literally puts stuff on the stove by itself. And there's a pan, I'm guessing, or pot, whatever. And there's a hob oven. And then they actually have real sinks as well. So we put two sinks right here. They actually work as well. So that's another thing I really like about this. Not only do they have more stuff than Millionaire Mansions 1, but most of the stuff in this also works. The toaster apparently doesn't, but they have a toaster. And then there's a microwave. I love how the little chicken goes in there. And the thing that's just awesome, it literally spins around in there. You can take that chicken, go ahead and eat it. And then, so they have regular fridges and double fridges. I decided to use the double fridge here. So you guys can see, that's supposed to be like a water thing where you put your cup over and you press the button and the water comes down. And I'm not really sure what that is. But either way, it literally opens up. You can see all the food and stuff inside. It's absolutely sick. And they also have working trash cans as well. If you guys watched the previous video, you guys saw me complain that they should have had working trash cans, but we don't have to have that problem anymore because I'm in Millionaire Mansions 2 now and they have working trash cans, so we don't have to have that problem. And now we are moving on to the table. They have different kinds of tables. The glass one is definitely my favorite. And then you got the chairs as well. You can go ahead and sit down in them. And then over here is the living room. This is just absolutely sick, guys. Look at this. So they have real couches, chairs. They work just like animals. So that's why it says tap sneak to exit, because that's what it would say if you were like jumping on an animal or something. So they're basically, I wouldn't really say they're substituted because animals are still in the game, but it's like a replica and they just disguise it as a chair so it's actually functional. And then they have tables too, this wooden table. I just love this. And then I just use the Millionaire Mansions 2 version of the dark oak planks to put speaker towers on top of. And then here's a wall-mounted TV. I just put this thing, even though the TV's not sitting on top of it, it still looks really cool. It's just a nice touch I added. And then upstairs, obviously we have the bedroom. So there's only two in this house because the top floor isn't that big, because I wanted to do this balcony thing. So that's probably why if I didn't do this balcony thing, I could have had all this other room right here, and I probably could have added, I don't know, maybe three more bedrooms. I just decided to keep that open because I think it looks really cool. You have an overview of the kitchen and stuff. It's really cool. So there's two bedrooms here. This is mine, and then just, I don't know, if I have a friend join this world, this can be his bedroom. But yeah, here's my bedroom. I have this, I forget what this bed is called, but I just really like the design of it. There's bars go up, and there's like a thing that goes over. I think it's really cool. And then I put dark oak planks right there, just a block, and then a flower pot with a little flower. And then also they have working dressers. Now, if you guys saw the last video, you guys also saw that I complained about them not having working dressers either. Well, now they do. this world is just insane. And they have an aquarium.
Wow.
And then this is the same design I did in the last video in Millionaire Mansion 1. I did doors between the walls so you can just go right from one room to the other. Now in this one, the guest is pretty lucky. He literally has a swinging chair that's hanging and you can swing around in it. And then they just have a regular bed. I just put a regular bed there. Again, we have the flower pot with the flower in it. There's that floor. And now, this may be, well, there's actually two cool parts in this house. And you guys just got a sneak peek right there. So because you did, I'm just gonna go right on ahead to this room. Look at this car, dude. It looks like a Tesla, basically, because the doors are open by the sides. So even though it's called like a neon car, I think, I'm just gonna call it a Tesla. Like, come on. This is basically a Tesla. The doors open to the sides, and then I also got a black motorcycle here. And this is also another design I did in the last video. I just put like a little platform for it to sit on. And I made another garage that has a limousine in it. Like, look at this thing. This is absolutely massive. And then behind it, we even got the yellow supercar. It's got a spoiler, dude. This world, it's just, I can't even talk right now. Like, it's just absolutely insane, the amount of things that are in this world. And then also, I forgot to mention, so if you came in that door here, here's like a little lounge area when you first come in, and I put two chairs there and a coffee table. And then now, here we go, guys. The last part of the video, definitely the most sick part. And you guys probably thought, out of all the parts you've seen so far, the cars in the garage, all those super sick cars, was the best part of the video. Once you see this, I think you're going to change your mind. Look at this, boys. I even put ceiling fans. We got a couch here. We got couches to sit on. But then this thing, we got the gaming setup. You can literally sit in this chair, too, so you can act like you're actually recording. Because they even got a microphone that comes with this. Three monitors set up, because now they actually have little computers. And they have the working computer box that controls it all. They got the gaming mouse, the keyboard. This is just absolutely sick. And then I put another little monitor over here. Well, it's actually a TV, but I just made it act like a monitor so that I can just come over here in case I need to do anything on this monitor. And then, like I said, we have these two couches you can just sit around and lounge over there. And yes, guys, again, they also have Xboxes in Millionaire Mansion 2 as well, as you guys can see. I'm pretty sure that's a VR headset. I didn't really recognize it as I was creating this and decorating this house, but now I'm starting to see it. It's a VR headset. Unfortunately, it doesn't actually function, but still, that's pretty sick. And then you got the Xbox controller. Not really sure what that is. But yeah, and then you got the console. You got the games on top. And then here's another couch you can just sit. And another very, very cool thing that they added in Millionaire Mansions 2. They got a curved TV, dude. Like, literally. Again, it's another thing that doesn't function, but just the way it looks. Even without something on the screen, it just looks absolutely sick. And then you got the two tower speakers like there were upstairs in the living room. And then I put another platform on the other side with the Nintendo Switch, as you guys can see. And yeah, you guys change your mind now? Like, what about that? Come on. You thought the cars were cool. Just look at that. It literally got a full-on gaming PC over there. Like, what the heck? What, like... I didn't even think that Minecraft would ever add that, but then yet today, I see that they've literally added this in the world. Like, what the actual heck? Alright, but guys, so that's going to do it for today's video. Now, of course, if you did enjoy it, make sure to subscribe, slap the bell, and leave a like in this video. And I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.